I'm Mads Peter. I work as partly like a multi-artist, or at least that's where I started. And now I work as a cultural entrepreneur, landscaper, architect, organizer, teacher, and a lot of other stuff. So I'm kind of still multidisciplinary, but away from the art. That was very, very little about me. And then we have the Institute of X. That's where you are. And that brings me back to the unprogramming thing. The X is also, that's a variable. And it has been that from the beginning, both representing like the direction of the place and the space, but mainly as a variable for the humans that are here. So the space has grown out of variables.
Hi.
That means that the X, the Institute, the whole Institute, again, back to the human as a resource and as an analog partner and a, let's say, a motor for doing stuff. So this whole place has been made up by individuals in a common space. I've seen like 1/3 of you before here, something like that. How many has been here before? I was almost a third, like exactly. And the rest of you are here for the first time. And it's good to have new people here. We've been doing a little bit like open, closed stuff, and it has been hard to like, how do we interact with this space? It's been easier for some of the younger guys and a little harder for the older people to understand the space, I think. Okay, that was very short about me and the X. And so that's the first time I ask, is there any questions about those first two things? Mm-hmm. About the X. Okay, I can give you some keywords. You're in an exhibition right now. There's like a lot of different titles around. And for one thing, we have X is a temporary project. And in the temporariness, it's that means it has a deadline. And that's Christmas Eve 2014. At least that's some kind of direction we got from the city. So the people that know the space, how could you see, or what do you see in this space as something that gives something to Aarhus? Like what's the possibilities for spaces like this in a city? That's one thing. Let's say possible direction. Is there any bits on a possible direction for a space like this? Like, what could we do to either make it like more public? Okay, unprogramming is a little bit hard in a speech. It's also a little bit hard on a daily basis. So, I'll try to elaborate on the overall thesis for a while. The future is analog. Let's get back to that. Future is analog. For this, in this exhibition that you're in right now, we use this as a think tank and exhibition and like a status report for the Institute of X. In this here, where the future is analog, we've been working on different levels, but we have one level that is city planning. We skipped the question. Now I just talk about different stuff that comes to my mind. We still ask questions. City planning. Since after the World War II, city planning has been based mainly on technology and modernism. If we could have big spaces and we could have easy transport, and if we had some, like the latest thing is like facades that have televisions in them and stuff like that, media facades. All that is very good, and I think it would still fit like 70% of how you plan cities. But in that, how you do there, you kind of lose the human, you lose the analogness in the human. Because the human exists mainly on Tuesdays in windy and rainy weather. Once in a while, the weather is good and perfect and fits modernism. But the Tuesday, with a little bit of too much wind, that suits for something else. There you need cities that have another kind of planning that has a more intimacy in them. So we've been working on this. Let's call it medieval modernism, where we try to take the good things from modernism and we try to take the good things from the old city. The old cities, they have grown out of a need, out of who was there, out of time, made up by different things, a butcher, some residence, some office, and in a very, very small scale. The cities, they also have one building attaching to the next building, stuff like this. Modernism has the monolith, and it has the it has to be cheap. It has to be doable. So we kind of try to put these two together and say, okay, it has to be doable, it has to be cheap, but it also has to be small scaled. It has to be, the streets have to be a little bit broken. You have to have corners where life can be. You have to have some kind of unfinished buildings that can take the human in as a part of the building. So the building is for the human to interact with, not just to be in. That was one thing. And I'm looking around to get the next thing.
plans to break any corners, other places in the city, like just here?
If we have any plans to break other corners?
Just because you said you have to have broken corners in your lifetime, just kind of happen. But right now you're very much based here?
Yeah, we are based here, but the Institute of X is more a, let's say, a laboratory or a mock-up for some of these theses that would be good. So instead of just having a like a cardboard model, it's pretty big. It's like 30,000 square meter mock-up of some of these. And if we have any plans of, you said, breaking corners.
It's satellites.
Yeah. But I like the breaking corners part.
Well, what I mean is that when you walk around the city, there's so much concrete, and we should pretty much break up some corners and do some stuff.
Yeah. I think that some of the places are lost causes. So I think you can do small interactions and stuff like that, but it will never be like entirely for humans, because it's in the basic form, it's simply too hard to interact with. So, and I think that's also, that's fine. I don't have a problem with the large spaces with concrete, because it can't all be coziness. You also need a place for the big telemarketing company to have like 200 offices in one space. And okay, so you need that in a city as well. So it's kind of the variation is also if you zoom out, you need like a space, okay, here they can just like live 20,000 people. It's not very interesting, but it's cheap. Here you have like big companies and they can live as they want and there's lots of parking and it's fine. And here you have a big, big art museum and it's fine. But you need the other spaces as well. You need the parts of the city where you want to stay for a longer time. That is not the recreational, just a green lawn, but you also have some kind of craftsmen doing stuff, shops selling different things, a small company with just like three guys. Parts of the city that has that intimacy. But you said if we have plans to go other places and break corners, and you said satellites. For the time being, no. But in a little while, yes. Because we are, right now we are here, and we have 7 buildings. So the X has been expanding like, and now there's no more free buildings. There was a lot of empty buildings falling apart and without electricity, and the electricity sometimes still goes. Every day. But so now we kind of gotten to where the Institute of X cannot grow that much down here. So the next thing would, of course, be to start looking at other places where we could facilitate this kind of culture. If there is people who need to be facilitated, as here, it's a human before the idea. So let's say that there was, over the next 7 months, there was 40 people that came and said, hey, we need space. I would probably start talking to some guys up in the system and say, okay, are you in or out? And there's lots of people in the city system that are in. So it's possible that we would do satellite, but again, depends on other stuff. And then that would start breaking corners somewhere else. Ja. A little bit about this. Ny kommune. You have the old kommune and you have the new kommune. The old kommune, you know. The new kommune, that's us. And us and the old kommune. This is old kommune. This is new kommune. Old kommune is way bigger, but it can't be in the board. Ny kommune is a philosophy, and again, just a statement. It's not a functional organ or anything like that. It's a part of this big laboratory where we try and say, okay, what's interesting? What can we follow? Is there something over here that is interesting? And let's say there's like 100 things that comes up, like Ny Kommune. Then there's maybe actually only 3 ideas that's a good. That's a laboratory. Ny Kommune, that's again the facilitating people that old kommune maybe cannot facilitate. It's taking the responsibility for the development of the city a little bit more into your own hands and doing the stuff, not sitting back and being, oh, it's also too bad that the harbor is just modernism. So we go to the harbor dudes and say, hey, it's a pretty bad plan you got going. And they listen a little bit. That's one thing. In Ny Kommune, we also have road research, which is like a toolkit that can close down streets. We do this in collaboration with Old Kommune. So if people call us and say, we would like to close off the street, can you help us? We say, yes. Yes, we can. And we call the Old Kommune and say, we need to close this street for a weekend. Is that okay? And they say, yes. So we kind of help the public to communicate with the Old Kommune, because the Old Kommune is so big and it can be very hard to understand where to go and what to do. That's the same place, the same thing about X. It can be very hard to call the city. Do you have some cheap square meters where we can be a little bit dirty and just do what we like to do? And so people call us and say, hey, do we have a place where we can be a little bit dirty and do stuff on our own? Yes, we do. And then I talk to the guys in the city, and most of the time they're happy, and other times they are a little bit, hey, now it's too much. You take too much freedom. Oh yeah, that's true. And then we ease down a little bit. That happened yesterday. So, And yeah, that was Ny Kommune. And I think it's pretty easy to put new stuff on the Ny Kommune. And and I think there's something in it that we would like to do more laboratory work on. And then I think the next thing, maybe next year or in the fall or something like that, would be to start up some talks with Old Kommune about looking at this cell a little bit more serious and say, okay, how can we actually do this so Old Kommune is part of it and not just being cheated to be part of it. That's a little bit the same. School is good. Institute of X. Institute, that's something you have on in schools. You have it in architectural school and you have it on a university. So we chose the name Institute to kind of accept the learning part and the laboratory. So down here we have, instead of it's one school, it's like maybe 10 schools, people from 10 different schools that interact with each other and kind of develops knowledge and projects stuff together. And that's also for the future. I think there's something in this trying to take different institutions and make this interact on a, again, the human scale, let the individuals easier interact with other schools. Because now it's, if it's a university, it's okay, we have 30 students that has to work with 30 students from over here, and then once in a while that gets a little bit awkward and not so for real. And we kind of experienced down here that it gets very much for real when it's more, it's not one-on-one, but it's a little bit more one-on-one. Individuals that has to do projects together, and maybe it's 1 + 1 + 1 + 1, so it ends up being 20 people working together, but they are from a lot of different places. That's one thing about school. Then we have another thing about school. We have some really young kids down here that doesn't fit into the normal Danish school because they don't know how to sit on a chair and they don't know how to read very well. And again, the analog as a learning tool is immensely good. And the project as a engine for this type of kids is also convincing when you see it in action. So this whole school thing is also something for the future, and maybe accepting that more kids need to learn by having stuff in their hands and not looking at stuff on an iPad. Because they need more success stories, and the success story can be a little bit more true if you can see what you do, if you can see what you learn. That was school. Any questions to school? It looks like a lot of people here are in school. Then we have, let's take the space you're in right now. This is DAC, which is a space for design, architecture and art, in Danish, design, architecture, kunst. Space is a little diffuse word, and that's this space is also that. And it's a space trying to really make tværæstetisk. I'm not sure about that in English. But work with this every day and not just architects doing a little bit of art once in a while, designers doing a little bit of architecture, but on an everyday basis try to take these three things and squeeze them together. And in this space, in the beginning we called it more like a gallery. But that was boring. It didn't investigate enough. It didn't, It was like the other galleries or museums that you put stuff up, and the only thing that was left was that there had to be a lot of people coming looking at it. Because if that didn't happen, it didn't make sense. So instead, we took this working museum thing and we stuffed it into DAC and said, okay, we do not have a gallery where you just put it up and then it's an exhibition as normally. We have to work in the exhibition. So this year is an experiment in doing an institution, exhibition institution that can do something else. And this one also has a huge amount of unprogramming, mainly unprogramming. Once in a while we have a program that is understandable, like right now. We have a think tank called This Is X. But on an everyday basis, it's a little harder for people to get in here. Because you come in and say, is it open? Yes, kind of open. Is there something we can see? Yes, you can try, but it's really hard to navigate in. And we don't have time to answer because we're working. That's a bad gallery, but it's an interesting space to be in. That's the institute, that's like the, again, that's between, it's between school and school commerce and gallery. Tegnestue, don't know that in English. So I have this acting in the same space. And I don't know if for the future that is very good on a larger scale, but I think that a lot of the... I think for some things it could be also a direction to look at. For architects, you have architects in the school. They kind of learn the laptop and then they do a little bit of models. You could get... I think some interesting new generations of architects, if they had the possibility to choose one line at school that had something like this, where it's commerce, art, design, handcraft, these things in the school. So that's probably some of the next things, that's talking to the architectural school. How can we interact with you guys where you still feel that your students are learning what's says in the paper from the government? But again, trying to push that institution in a direction where you get some architects that are maybe a little bit more on level with real world and not just the cardboard in the studio. Maybe. That's actually it on the time. That's good and bad. Because I only got like the three headliners. I feel like I could go on for 2 hours at least.
Yeah, okay. You just said about working together at the architecture school, but isn't it also that people give the assignments there maybe a problem? Like, I think, isn't it maybe difficult for architects if they focus too much on this to get a job or get work done anyway? Because for the Kommune and what business order is like, very functional, maybe modernist, but doesn't really post-modernist buildings next to a highway and a lot of office space.
That's the Gordic knot.
Right.
Yeah, in architecture. So yes, it is. And the Gordic knot is like this Greek thing, and you can only solve it with like a sword. So it's part of that. It's part of a like a big interactive like developers, the city and the school, the language, the jobs, everything that's kind of makes up for how it is. But I think that this thing could help solving a little bit of this, maybe, together with some of the other things I said earlier.
To how to maybe abandon the idea of big concrete and modernist buildings, and also the commune, especially if they make a new, I don't know, public transportation system or maybe buildings or other public buildings. Do you actually advise them or try to because they are basically the ones that give the assignment?
We just got to that part. We started out as a street party 10 years ago, and now we are a little bit closer to being some kind of philosophic tegnestue, and we are trying to elaborate on ideas that come out of another system, and we are trying to work on how to translate this so it's understandable for the Gordic knot, because it's really hard to talk to the Gordic knot if you don't have the proper language, and if you have the proper language, you repeat. So we are trying to invent a language that can talk to this unit, and that unit is the developers, the investors, the school, the city, urban planners. That's everybody. So. But to answer, yes, we are. But we just started on it, and. But we did just like 2-3 months ago, we talked to Dokken. We were invited down there to say something. You can come and say something radical to us. I said, okay, yeah, we can come and say something radical, yes. And we came down there and we said, okay, let's not say something that's too radical. Let's just say some things that we can see that could make this project a little bit better. Or a little bit more interesting, or a little bit more human. And we were not trying to be radical. We were just like, it was, that's not modernism. So it's hard. But this space, Godsbanen as area, that gives us some kind of reason to talk a lot with the city about how do we do it here, or not how do we do it, how do you do it, city? Because you can repeat what you usually do, or you actually have a possibility to try to do it in a different way. And that thing, you have a possibility to do it in a little bit different way. I think they are gonna catch up on it. So hopefully in 10 years you can see a part of the city that is based on something else than just modernism.
Do you look at the other cities for inspiration? Is there any city you can name that got this right?
There's some places where they tried a little bit, but it's... not very much, because the last 30 years architecture has been monolith architecture. That one. So you have that one, then you have grass and a road, then you have the next building pretty far away, and you have grass and a road. And that's kind of how you do it, and that's how architects learn to draw buildings. They draw this type of building 95% of the time. Then they have 1 week where they learn to argument for this. So the language, the whole language is this. in all the schools. But there's some good examples from Sweden, and also Holland has some pretty good areas where they try to do it. But it doesn't happen very much.
I wanted to ask, how do the citizens of all come here to act, and how do you bring a project? How do you, if you have an idea, if you don't fit in school, because it seems like it's very open, but still kind of closed, but maybe too busy to take care of people. So it's hard to see how you can just walk in and say, hey, I would like to do some beatboxing like Osmos, and do you have some room for me? How do you do that? How do you use Institute for X as a own citizen?
That's easy and it's hard. A lot of people come here and say, what can I do? And I don't know. Can't do anything. But what do you want to do? So it's, you're asking a little bit of the way in?
Well, yeah, because you know, it's actually for both, right? Because let's say you don't fit in and would like to find a place to fit in, but you might not have an idea of a project. But also you might have a project, but yeah, you need a place to be.
It's easier to get in if you have a project. Or you have an idea, okay, this is my direction. That's one thing. And then that depends on the idea, what you want to do. If you just want to do a table and a chair and stuff like that, say, if you just need a wood workshop, there's a really good wood workshop right up here at Gåsbanen. There's people working there and they're being paid to help you. Please go there. If 2 days ago there was a new unit which landed in the garden, and there was some guys from Diem who came down and said, hey, we really need a space where we can do our school stuff which is not in school. And I said, okay, we don't have any more studios for that, but you can buy your own studio and put in the garden. So they knew some guy that had like an old skurvogn that they could buy. Well, it's not so old actually, it looks pretty good. And they bought it, and they had a truck come here and put it. So if you have that amount of self-power, it's pretty easy to get in.
If then talk to you, or
yeah,
you
yeah, yeah. Just call me. And there's it's called. We have there's one meeting, and it's what's that? Design and finance. It's called like, and the design is not shape, but it's social. Like, who are you? What do you do? Why do you want to be here? Try to like, where should this UFO land in this system? Okay, the sound people, they can either fit out there or over there, but it depends on what they do. The carpenter guy that just wants to help around, okay, please more of those. then that was 1 week ago, and Alexander had a tour with that guy. He was a carpenter and he had some spare time, and he met, he was introduced to 4 or 5 people down here, said, but these are the people that normally have the projects where we build stuff, so you should know these guys, and then we can call you if we need help. So it depends very much on what you are and what you want to do. And then there's all the event makers, like party people, cultural outputs and stuff like that, and that they are kind of, they can fit in many places. So again, it's just call and ask. But you also ask about how can the public get in and do stuff, and it is a little bit hard, and we don't have very much time to service because we don't get any funding for that. And we, in the beginning, we found out, okay, that's pretty fast. That's a full-time job for somebody just saying hello and trying to make people understand what it is and how they can fit in. So we had an event one half year ago, which was open to close. So we opened to be more closed.
I think that will have to be the last question. It's getting close to 9.
Yeah.
But thank you so much.